A new hereditary cancer risk assessment program is helping identify specific cancers in women and men across Connecticut. Here to explain how it works is nurse practitioner Megan Burgess of Midstate Radiology Associates with Hartford Healthcare. Yes. Thank you so much for being here,
Megan. Thank you for having me.
Why is it so important to have this type of assessment program?
Right, so we're identifying women at risk for certain types of cancer, specific through a mammography program, but we not only identify their risk, but also manage it. So we coordinate their care.
So you're rolling it out through the mammography program?
Yes.
And so that means men can also take part in this?
That's correct. In families, we often see people start with the women having their annual mammogram, but then it extends to children, siblings, husbands, so yes.
So how important is this program in actually identifying these risks?
Oh, it's hugely important. It's a life changer, certainly. We are seeing, we're certainly saving lives. You know, once we identify women and their families at higher risk for these cancers, there are things that we can do in order to lower their risk or prevent those cancers from actually occurring.
So how successful is it then in actually yes. identifying these markers?
Hugely successful. So we rolled the program out in our mammography suites about a year ago, over a year ago. Identified over 25,000 women, have tested well over 1,200 and have 70 mutation positive individuals. So we really are saving lives.
What happens when they actually take part in this program?
Sure.
Folks really have to be prepared, I think, to deal with whatever the
of
results
course.
Are, right? So
yes.
they have to kind of know what they want to do with that information.
Right, and that's the other important piece of this. It's not only just as simple as a genetic test, but it is. It's a saliva test in that way. It is simple, but it goes beyond that. And part of our program, and part of my role as a nurse practitioner, is to counsel those patients, the pre-test counseling on the phone with a genetic counselor, mm-hmm. and then post-test counseling with me in order to coordinate their care and really explain the impact of those results.
So what do you actually say to these folks when they
sure.
come in? And let's just say they actually, the results show that they're at high risk for
sure.
certain cancer, breast cancer,
right.
cervical, whatever it is. What do you
yes.
say to them?
Well, a lot of times it's actually a relief. Some people worry that, you know, patients will be anxious, but a lot of times I find the patients already knew that they were at high risk, and now it's almost, it decreases their anxiety because now they know that they have the knowledge and they can do things to prevent that cancer from occurring, additional screening options that are now available, insurance will cover it, additional surgeries that they wouldn't have had to prevent that cancer from occurring. So it's actually you know, hugely beneficial to them, and again, it impacts their families as well.
So people who take part in this, should they know that they have a family history, or does it matter that they don't know that they have a family history?
Usually, you know, part of when they have their mammogram is they do report their family history because there is certain criteria that needs to be met in order to offer testing to them.
Very good. And this just started recently, this program.
Yes, and we are the only radiology providers in the state of Connecticut and one of the first in the nation to offer this on-site telegenetics testing. So it's very exciting.
How long does it take to get the results back?
It takes about 4 to 6 weeks to get the results and to meet with me to go over those results.
So specifically in the lab, what are they looking at?
So they're looking at 28 genes. So we are using the most comprehensive genetic sequencing that is available.
Mm-hmm.
The only FDA-approved lab is what we've chosen as our lab. So we test for the 8 most common types of hereditary cancer. So breast, ovarian, colon, uterine, pancreatic, and prostate cancers.
That's great.
Yeah. Very
great information for people out there who really want to know. And of course, what you use that information for
yes.
will help you with treatment and et cetera as
sure.
you follow through.
Absolutely.
Thank
yes.
you.
Thank you for having me.
You're so welcome.